Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to another video on my channel, HAIRLICIOUSLY. If you guys are new to the channel, please make sure to hit that subscribe button so you guys are updated on hair loss and hair transplant topics, as well as updates on current hair loss treatments in the pipelines. Visit my website at hairlicious.com to purchase your microneedling device, which is scientifically proven to stimulate hair growth, my low-level laser therapy cap, DHA debulking shampoo, conditioner, and serum, hair growth vitamins, and a few other products to help those who are losing hair. So the other day, I saw an interesting post on Reddit's Tresla subpage regarding the progression of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un's hair loss transformation over the past few years. And since this is an interesting topic, I figured that I would do a video for you guys. A lot of my content is derived from Tresla, so if you've never heard of it, I would recommend that you guys check it out because it is solely dedicated for hair loss. And you can find, you know, a lot of good information ranging from anything from like, you know, hair transplants to before and after results from using various hair loss treatments. All sorts of, you know, very good information. I will talk about Kim Jong-un's hair loss and his hair transformation in just a little bit. But before I get started, I wanted to give you guys a quick update on North Korea. If you guys didn't know, when it comes to basically everything that you do in North Korea, from something as trivial as type of hairstyle you have, the clothes you wear, down to what you watch or listen on the radio or TV, it's all highly scrutinized by the government. They'll severely punish anybody who tried to adapt to just anything indicative of Western fashion trends and prevent capitalistic culture and lifestyle from, you know, trying to take over the country. They go as far as to limit what, you know, like I said, the hairstyles you can actually get at the local barber. And they literally have like this approved list anywhere from like 10 to 15 very similar hairstyles that you can only get. And the same principle also applies to women. Deviating anything outside of this list would be deemed anti-socialist, and there would be pretty severe consequences if you were to go against the regime's strict policy. But you know, I guess one way to really get out of this is if you're balding or if you're bald because you're going to be lacking hair to style. But anyway, ever since Kim Jong-un became North Korea's supreme leader in like the late 2011, he's always seen sporting a few variations of the iconic hairstyle with the shaved sides and the long top and center part. Almost resembling that of like an upside down trapezoid. And the signature hairstyle has probably been one of the number one attributions creating his image to this day. And just for shits and giggles, I posted this a couple years ago. A few Halloweens, I dressed up as Kim Jong-un and my wife was my fellow nuke. But anyway, here is a photo of the dear leader in 2015 at the age of 31. We can clearly see that this guy had a full head of hair with no signs of hair loss or temple recession. I would easily place him in the Nord 1 category given his relatively, you know, a straight hairline, and he also looks like he has some really good density, nice thick black hair. And is that Kim Jong-il, who lived to the age of 70, also had a decent amount of hair right before he died, although given his age we can see some visible and reasonable diffuse hair miniaturization in the frontal area and parts of his scalp. But generally speaking, he probably had, you know, more hair than the average Joe who had reached into their early to mid 70s. Now, going further down or going further up into his family history of hair loss, here's a photo of his paternal grandfather, Kim Il-sung, who died at the age of 82. And he also had some pretty good density. So relatively speaking, there's not much androgenic alopecia lurking, at least on his paternal side. Here is another shot of Kim Jong-un in 2019 at age 35, and yet we can still see a pretty solid looking hairline for someone who is in their mid-30s. Something to note is where his temporal points are located. They're placed right above the edge on the tip of his eyebrows. And also notice how the temporal angles are slightly below 90 degrees, giving him that kind of like boxy or that boxed-in hairline. This will be useful when we compare it with another image that I'm about to show you that shows his hair loss progression over the past couple years. Now, nevertheless, you know, he still has incredible hair density with really thick black hair here. And then fast forward to the end of 2021, there was an article by the New York Post titled, "Kim Jong-un worked so hard last year, he completely withered away," state media claims. And in this photo here, we can clearly see a much more unexplained thinner version of Kim Jong-un, and more noticeable, especially for the hair loss community, people who are lurking, is his receding hairline along with his white hair. Now, if you look at his temporal angles, before they were more closer to that of a 90 degree angle, giving him that boxy hairline. But now it has definitely receded to that of a sharper acute angle. It's probably closer to more like 45 degrees. The mid part of his hairline also looks to be slightly thinned out, and we can see a bit through the scalp. And more noticeable is the temples on both sides with more recession than how they were before. He still has a good amount of hair and density left, but he has definitely lost some ground. And it's more like a no or two at this point. Now, with that said, you know, his hair is probably better than most men in their late 30s. And honestly speaking, I don't really think Kim Jong-un is actually afflicted with genetic hair loss at this point. It looks more like a mature hairline, since most people are not going to be able to keep their adolescent hairlines in the first place. And most people who aren't balding will eventually develop a maturing hairline that has slightly some form of recession on the temples. And this is actually totally normal. Most men also tend to develop a maturing hairline into their mid-20s, or, you know, even into their mid-30s. And for Kim Jong-un's case, this happened towards the end of his 30s. A maturing hairline for most individuals could also recede, you know, just a little bit, like I stated, meaning the forehead can appear to be wider or longer. The temples can recess to a small extent. And also up close, Kim Jong-un doesn't appear to have any smaller or shorter thinning hairs on the frontal part of the hairline. That could actually represent actual miniaturization. Now, with that said, this isn't to say that he won't progress further into a NOR3+, as hair loss can be pretty unpredictable at any age, even well past your 40s and 50s. And even if you're not predisposed to genetic hair loss, aging will cause slower hair growth, hairs can thin out. And if we take a look at his assassinated half-brother, Kim Jong-nam, whom he shared fathers with, he was suffering from a more extensive form of hair loss with a near complete bald head, probably like a NOR6, NOR7 status. So it is possible, but if we look into his paternal family history of hair loss, his father and his grandfather especially, nobody had really suffered from any moderate hair loss to the point that progressed past a NOR3, NOR4 diffuse pattern. So at this point, I still think that Kim Jong-un's hair is looking solid for someone who is nearly 40 years of age. And in my opinion, will likely progress slowly over the next coming years. Now, his health has also been a source of, you know, much speculation for years, and his public appearances are closely tracked for insights about the autocratic and secretive regime in Pyongyang, especially since his family has a history of heart disease. And there were speculations that he had been ill and suffering from long-term diabetes and high blood pressure. So given what we know, and given the possibility of Kim Jong-un's health conditions, I really wouldn't suspect that he would be on any type of hair loss medications like finasteride or minoxidil that could potentially exacerbate his current condition, let alone, you know, like any other North Korean citizen taking hair loss medications. I can't even imagine him or other North Koreans, you know, like microneedling or taking anti-androgens to prevent hair loss. I can totally be wrong. Maybe he is on finasteride, just like his buddy Donald Trump, so that he can continue to basically just maintain his signature hairstyle, and perhaps others may also have access to such medications. But, you know, definitely his father and grandfather are very likely not on any type of hair loss medications. And the thing is, like, I don't even know if there are any hair loss or hair transplant clinics in North Korea. I first of all wouldn't trust them in the first place or their medical standards, and even if they did somehow have an incredibly skilled hair transplant doctor, there's no guarantee that you guys are going to make it out alive after, even after the procedure. And the thing is that if Kim Jong-un ever were to consider getting a hair transplant, if he were to continue to recede later down the road, he'd probably have to go to his closest ally, China, and get it done there, or source a Chinese doctor or a Russian doctor or whatever to do the procedure in North Korea or something. And looking at these photos here, which depicts the back of his head, it's clear to see that he hasn't gone through any previous strip or FU hair transplant surgeries. And I can confidently say that what he currently has is his natural hair. And one last thing is that, you know, I guess he's so afraid that people would try to assassinate him. So I think something even minor in terms of like surgery for hair transplant, I think this is something that he wouldn't even consider because of the fact that he might be just I guess really scared that someone might do something or do harm to him and potentially kill him. So in conclusion, this is my quick analysis on Kim Jong-un's hair loss. To recap, it doesn't look like he is suffering from any type of genetic hair loss, but rather it looks like it's just a maturing hairline that looks to have recessed on the temples just a tad bit and also on the temporal points. I would love to get your thoughts on what you guys think. Please do share in the comment section below. And if you guys have any celebrities or any high profile individuals that you guys want me to analyze, let me know in the comment section below and I'll try to do an analysis on the comment that gets the most likes. Anyway, thanks for watching guys. Thanks for all of your support. If you guys like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and I will talk to you guys in my next video. Take care.